A lot of the stories that we've been hearing and experiencing as we've been traveling through the Solomon Islands are relatively unheard or unknown stories of the Second World War. One of the more famous stories is that of former US President John F. Kennedy being involved in the war here in the South Pacific, and the ramming of his PT-109 boat that split it in half and sent him and his crew into the water. This is the island that they actually came ashore on. The boat wrecked somewhere out over here, and they drifted in with the currents and then started swimming towards the nearest small little island they could find. The story that's not so famous is the heroic tales of two Solomon Islanders who actually rescued him and his crew, managed to get messages between him and the Allied base by inscribing coconut shells and taking those back and forth so that they looked completely incognito.
What they were risking was their own lives and the lives of their families, because if the Japanese found out that they were helping to smuggle out these survivors, you know, there's no two ways about it, they would have been killed.
This wasn't their war, and yet they were still heavily involved.
What we've learned just recently over the last few days is actually one of those guys who helped rescue John F. Kennedy still actually lives and survives today. And we're going to go and pay him a visit.
We're going to hop in our boat and go off with two of Aaron's sons to go see the man himself, the hero himself, one of two men responsible for saving John F. Kennedy's life. Hi.
Hi.
Scott. What's your name?
John F. Kennedy.
John F. Kennedy. Your name is John F. Kennedy.
Yes, my name is John F.
All right. The man made enough of an impression on Aaron that he felt it was an honor to name one of his sons after the late president.
All Aaron's granddaughters and grandsons.
We just landed on Renanga and we're graced by the presence of Aaron's grandchildren. All this area here is Aaron's land. Everyone worldwide has heard of JFK. He never would have lived to have seen his presidency had it not been for Aaron and his friend.
Oh yeah, Ronnie got it.
How are you, sir? My name is Scott.
Good. We all are good. He said,
hello.
Old, but he's
how are you?
Still good.
Good. As usual, we draw a crowd. Most of the people here are probably either children or grandchildren of Aaron. And it's sort of funny to see all these faces gathered around. For us, like, we're the important one when we've come all this way to visit him, because obviously he's the important one. This is a photograph here of the gravesite of John F. Kennedy. They've actually placed a piece of traditional Solomon Islands shell money. The remnants of those are really quite an honor. We're very honored to spend some time with such a heroic man. What did Aaron think of John F. Kennedy?
Oh, I got my Kennedy. Kennedy, the warrior.
Kennedy is one of the warriors, because he started fighting from Guadalcanal and fighting everywhere, then his ship was sinking. So when he met him, he said, Kennedy is a warrior.
When he met
Kennedy told them to go and get the boat to come and pick up the cruise.
And did Aaron hide John F. Kennedy in his canoe when he was paddling?
Yes.
Why did he have to hide John F. Kennedy in the boat?
Sometimes the Japanese planes fly over them, so he have to hide him in a coconut leaf.
The way that they were able to sneak messages past the Japanese back to the Allied forces is they actually carved writing into coconut shells. It's easy enough to just flip that over in the bottom of a canoe like that and have a heap of coconuts, two or three of them with messages on them, and the Japanese Imperial forces would never know. It's pretty smart. We feel very proud and very lucky, very honored to spend some time with him, and we thank him.
He also thank you for you come and visit him. All of you is praying, he said. My
thank
second.
You. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
You see all these people just having a peaceful little life here. You look out at the ocean on a beautiful day like today and you wonder how war could have ever found a little place like this. It's really hard to picture. The wreckage is still here to see, and people like Aaron are here to speak to still get a first-hand account before there is no more first-hand accounts left.